Praise the Lord. Today's reflection. It is the love of God that came down in the person of Jesus, the Son of God, to be with us. God knows the greatest problem of man is the absence of the divine presence and the trick of the enemy, that is to create fear. The presence of the fear destroys everything, and the presence of God and His presence and conscious of His love casts away every type of fear. We read in Job chapter 3 verse 25, Job says, "What I feared has happened to me. My fear has come behind me and destroyed me. Though the Lord did everything good for him, he had inside the fear, what will happen to me? What will others think of me?" That has been used by the enemy. When there is fear, the enemy enters into us. It is because of the enemy. Fear, Herod wanted to kill Jesus, and at the end he killed so many infants. It is because of the fear, the prophet Elijah ran away from the queen called Jezebel in 1 Kings chapter 19. It is the fear that made Saul to run after David to kill him. Yes, fear has brought so much havoc in the life of people, because in the fear there is the enemy, the presence of Satan. So we need to overcome the fear. That's why the psalmist teaches us the secret to live, to glory, to life. And that secret is Psalm 34 verse 4 and 5. "I sought the Lord, and He delivered me from all fears, and He trained me to look unto Him. When I looked unto Him, my face began to shine. He took away all shame." Psalm 23 verse 4. "The Lord is my shepherd. Even if I walk in the valley of darkness, I will not be afraid, for He will be there with me." In Luke chapter 14 verse 27, Jesus Himself said, "Do not be afraid. Peace be with you. The peace I give you is not like the world that gives peace to you. Let not your hearts be troubled or frightened, for I am with you." Yes, God's heart of love establishes His presence again and again to those who seek Him. That's what today's first reading says. Perfect love casts away the fear. The more we focus on God's word, that He is with us, He is our shepherd, He is our Lord, and He has created us not to death but to life, because He loves us and He is in us. So His presence in us and His love for us casts away every fear. In the gospel of today we find it is to establish His presence. He multiplied the bread, and later He will establish the Eucharist to tell us that He is with us always. And He gave them that even in the deserted place, even in the terrible situation, our God is with us, and He will not allow us to go hungry and fall on the way. And He fed them. But the disciples did not understand the presence of the Master, the love of the Master, and what the presence of the Lord can do to us. So instead, they were traveling alone. They forgot what Jesus has done. They allowed the circumstances and the situations to overcome them, to fill their minds and to fill them with the fear. They saw the storm. They saw the wind. They began to cry. They thought, we are going to die. And when they saw Jesus, who was coming on the sea, they thought it's a devil. And they still all the more shouted. Jesus was praying alone with the Father. And he was not frightened, because he was conscious of the presence of the Lord. He was conscious of the mission God has prepared for him. And he will never die without fulfilling the purpose of the Father. So he had no fear. Yes. And Jesus, who was walking on the sea, told them, be not afraid. It is I. Yes. When he entered into the boat once again, the fear moved away from the hearts of the disciples. Today, the same God is coming into our hearts, telling us, be alert, that through fear, the enemy will destroy you. But fill yourself, establish your heart with my presence. Continue to read the word of God. The word of God, establish my presence, and live gloriously. Amen.